So wait, where's my notes? Right.
So this is chord changes with
Xavier. Chord changes 101.
Okay.
Chord changes with Professor X.
I will be asking you guys some questions.
Okay.
So how many major scales are there?
12.
Yes, there are 12 major scales, and essentially, chord changes are all based around those 12 major scales, and with those we can make minor scales and jazz, blues scales, and all kinds of different things. So that's how you get your different sounds. So to start off, in order to get started with chord changes, you have to work on memorizing those 12 scales. So you have B flat major, your F major, your
C major,
C major, all your major scales. And for today, I'll just be in generally talking about C major today to make things easy. No flats, no sharps, just C major.
All right.
So that way you can clearly see what's going on. And okay, here's a good question: how many notes do you need to make a chord?
Three.
Three?
Yeah.
Not two?
Three.
Three?
I mean two.
Answer is three. Okay. And you know what that's called, Andrew?
No.
Triad.
What the?
What is turn on the smart board.
What smart board?
This is dull. Mr. A.
Don't put the marker back. You have to separate it.
I'm not gonna throw it back.
I'm gonna edit this out.
Almost spelled that wrong. But so you need three notes to make a chord, because if you have two notes, your brain and your mind is gonna try and put a third note in there. Because if you play a G and a D, your brain's gonna, it might put a B flat in there, or a B or a C. It might try and put in different notes. So that's it, you don't get a complete chord with that. You just get kind of like harmonic, you know. It sounds good, but not complete.
Yeah. Right?
So triad, and then with the triad, there are different types of triads.
Ooh. Okay.
So then we have major triads. We have minor triads. We have diminished triads and augmented triads. And I feel like it's good to start off with these triads, because that way we don't start off with too many notes to worry about. We just kind of get the idea of what's happening here. So I'm going to write these on the board, actually. This marker is garbage. We have major, minor, diminished.
You said Mr. A's black one over there.
Yeah, but he usually uses that. If we use it, he might.
It's for learning. It's like we're drawing on the board.
Okay. Right. And the way we usually refer to the notes and chord changes, at least for this right now, we're going to do the scale degrees. So if we have C major, okay. Your first note is obviously going to be C, right? So we call that the root note, and that's the note you'll usually see. That's the note you will see when you're reading chord changes. You'll see the root note. So that tells you what scale you're going to be playing on, okay? So for major, okay, we're going to start off with C. So that's the one scale degree. And major scales are going to be 1, 3, and 5, okay? Gonna be one, but I don't want to put any other signs in there. One,
you put
comma.
Yeah, there you go.
3, 5. So in C major, C major. Sorry, I'm writing a little small. So in C major, that would be.
Mm-hmm.
What would the first note be?
C.
Second, third note. E. And fifth note.
G. Yeah.
So that's your triad.
Play this real quick.
So that's the triad.
That's one, three, and five right there.
That's very convenient.
Very convenient. But having this? Yeah. That's a triad. It's a major triad. It doesn't sound funky or weird, right? Uh-huh. Sounds kind of whole and sweet. If the piano was over here, I'd be playing the piano set, but this is our situation. So, that's major. Oh, wait, no, I'm going to get ahead of myself. And you'll see this on your chord changes as you'll get your little measure thing. One, two, three, four. And it'll say C. That's it. Or it might say C major. Right? Or it might say C with a triangle. Nice and sweet like that. Okay?
Alright.
So that's what you're gonna see. I'll write it next to here so you can have nice bulleted notes. Symbol will be C. Okay? Then we have minor. Minor is going to be your root note, one. What do you think is going to be different about a minor?
Half step lower.
On what? On which one?
Third note.
There you go, Kenneth. You know, flat, the third, and the fifth stays the same.
Okay.
So then we're going to have C, then what?
E flat.
Then G.
So that's easy. And then the symbol is going to be C with a minus sign. So here's a major one. 1, 3, and 5. And then 1 flat 3 and 5, which is a minor triad. A little bit nastier. So. battery. It's a little minor. It doesn't sound quite right. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir?
Would you recommend memorizing the 12 minor scales as well, or just focus on the majors?
Well, if you, at some point, I think that would help. But right now, if you know the minor scale, if you know all your major scales, and you can see that it's B minor 7, well, I'll say if it just says B minor, then you know to flat the third. Okay? So instead of having to try and think about the...
Is that the only difference between the major and minor scale? Or is there other differences?
Well, we're gonna get into this. This is the beginning. We'll get into more stuff later on. Okay, this is the very beginning.
The basics.
Very basics right now. Okay, I need. This is kind of close together.
That means there's gonna be a lot.
No, this is the four triads. Augmented. Wait, where?
Diminished.
Okay, diminished. Okay. So then we're going to have your root note. We already know we're going to have our flat 3. And then can you tell me what the fifth would be?
Flat 5.
Yeah.
So it all goes in order here. So we're going to have C,
flat.
E flat, and then what?
G flat.
G flat. Symbol for that will be. Wait, what's my symbol? Where's my symbol? It's gonna be C with a little circle. Like that. And also for G minor, not G minor, C minor, it could also say literally C minor right there.
Alright.
Right there. Alright? Am I writing neat enough? Can you guys read that? Alright, sweet. And then augmented, this is... Oh wait, I need to play the diminished one. So we're gonna have our major. Let's hope that my re doesn't poop on me again. Major. Minor. Diminished.
Ew.
And if you played all those together, it sounds a little bit nasty. Okay. Okay, and then your augmented. This one's a little bit different. So I won't. Yeah, I want someone to take a guess on what's going to happen here. So we have our one. What do you think the three is going to be?
I'm pretty sure there's a sharp there somewhere.
A sharp, maybe?
I'm pretty sure there's a sharp.
Well, the three is actually not flat.
It's...
What about the five, though? What do you do now? You can't have a major one. I know, it's kind of not an easy question.
Does it stay the same as diminished?
It would make it major. Sharp 5?
Sharp 5. I'm just taking a shot in the dark.
Yeah. Sharp 5.
Woo! Who can?
Yeah.
And this sounds really weird, too. E, C, almost with E flat. And then G sharp. And then the symbol will be... Usually don't see this too often. I guess the music we play usually doesn't have augmented triads in it. But you're gonna have a C. What a cute little plus sign right there. Alright? I don't think Miss Ray has erasers over there. Sweet. I'm starting off with the diminished triad. That already sounds pretty bad.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the augmented. Right?
Yeah.
That's your augmented triad. And triads, you know, guess what genre of music uses triads the most? Guess. Name some genres.
Jazz.
No.
R&B.
No, not R&B. R&B actually gets kind of difficult with
rock.
Reggae?
Pop music.
Pop?
So when you hear that Katy Perry or anything like that, you got the Hi Benedict. You're gonna have your basic triads because it's a little bit simpler for the human ear. I guess it just trends well. I don't write the music, I just listen to it. Okay, everyone have this down?
Yeah.
Everyone's got it written down?
I got it down.
What did I walk into?
Chord changes 101
for jazz.
Oh, I need to write that at the top of my board. All right, going away now.
All right, go ahead.
You have to do the.
Don't worry, you can watch it on YouTube.
Flipping physics.
Oh. I'll sit here. Okay, and then. So then.
Got two bars left. A battery.
2 bars left?
Yeah.
Boy,
well, it just drained.
You better be taking notes then.
Okay, so that's our triads. And then there's another scale which you'll see much more often in jazz, and that is... Wait for it. I'll let him run down his battery a little more.
Oh my gosh.
Well, we have our dominant... I'm gonna spell this wrong, I know I will. Oh Jesus. Please no. Dominant 7 chords.
You spelled it right.
Okay. Huh?
You spelled it right.
I spelled it right?
Yeah.
So in dominant 7 chords, we have 4 notes instead of 3. So we have 4 notes. Okay. And we're going to stick in C major right now because... easy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why I erased this part of it. C.
Mr. Rossa.
Okay,
whatever.
Whatever, right? So, these are a little bit different because we're going to have. Major 7.
Hey, Ben.
go in my front pocket.
We're going to have major seventh chords. And then we're going to have dominant. Dominant seventh chords. Am I narrating?
Sort of. Just keep writing. I'll get it.
Then we're going to have minor seventh. Minor seventh chords. And then we're going to have, this is where it really gets crazy. And we have half diminished. It's going to be fun when I quit you guys on this one.
Half diminished.
This is my handwriting. Half diminished. And then we're going to have fully diminished. If half diminished wasn't bad enough.
Fully developed.
Oh. I have unlimited battery.
Are you even portable in there?
Yeah.
Dude, I spelled diminished, bro. Oh my god.
Will there be a snack break?
A snack break?
Do we get nap time?
There is no sleeping in my class!
So it's just half diminished, no half diminished seven?
Well, okay.
Wait, I'm just asking.
Well, I mean, these are all seven chords.
Time for a commercial break.
Have you ever had chronic diarrhea?
Now you will.
Okay.
Until anus assault changed my life.
Okay. So, in a major seventh, you guys can probably tell me what the scale of this is. First note? Give me the scale degrees.
One, three, five.
Three.
Five.
We're still doing triads, right?
These are seven chords.
Oh. Seven.
And then seven.
Seven.
That's it.
Hey. Right.
This is a major seventh chord, so we're gonna have. Give me the notes for C major.
C, E, G.
This is Marcus Dyer. Okay.
C, E, G.
And then what?
A. No, B.
C.
B.
Oh, dang it.
Then we got B.
Right.
And then,
good. It's simple.
It's gonna sound pretty basic right here. Alright, this is the major seventh chord. It really doesn't sound that good because, you know, that C and the B, they're a little close together, so. That's a major seventh chord. You usually don't see that in jazz too much. Well, actually, no, you do. You see major chords.
Is there a symbol for this one?
Yes, sir. I'm gonna have to start write the symbols on this side.
Get rid of Wendy's.
No! Oh, it is? Not yet.
Not yet.
It's not time.
It's
okay.
Not time yet.
So then we're gonna have C7 or C triangle 7. You ever see that?
Let me get a close up on that.
Yeah, C major 7, C triangle 7, okay? And once you see that, oh, you better be slaying that chord. I already know you know what C major 7 is, Kenneth. I know you know what that is.
Wait, question. So there's a kind of random. So, are those notes the concert pitches?
Hmm?
Or those you just play them right off?
Those are the notes that is going to be played by the piano. What's up, dude?
Hey, what you doing?
Teaching chord changes. Chord changes 101.
Chord changes?
Yes, sir.
For what?
Jazz.
For jazz?
Yeah.
Oh, I need to learn this. Actually,
put up a chair. Get some notes. Let's go.
Say hi to the...
Hey, say hi to the cat.
Your girlfriend's angry you left her.
Right? Maybe for... Yeah, that's another reason why I couldn't do it.
Okay.
I'm sorry to interrupt your class.
No, it's fine.
Back to the...
So, these are the notes that the piano's gonna be playing. The piano's gonna be taking the four fingers and clamping on the C, E, G, and B.
I remember learning that when I was two.
So, if you see C major 7 and you wanna play some right notes, this is where it is. You play these notes. And yeah, so you can play the C major scale, but these are the notes. Since the piano's playing it, and guitar and bass,
mm-hmm.
This is what's gonna sound sexy. Okay? But... But, okay. So, you don't always want to just stick around these, but it's not wrong. Because this is what the band's going to be playing. So you're not going to be wrong about playing the chord tones. Actually, it's going to sound pretty good. I tried to do that in Doghouse. I tried to outline the chord changes a little bit.
Yeah.
So... Alright, then we have dominant seven. I'm trying to hurry up a little bit. We have one. Oh my god.
Get erased.
One. Next.
Three.
Oh my god.
You're
recording this in?
Five.
Yeah.
And then, what's the seven going to be?
Sharp. Seven sharp?
No, not sharp.
One.
Flat seven.
What?
Well, if you had a sharp 7, it would just end up at the root note. Okay. If I had a B sharp, I'd end up at C. True, and then true. I would end up with a triad.
I never figured there was actual logistics in music.
Oh.
Yeah, this is...
I didn't think. I was just like, just play it.
I mean, you could just play by ear.
Wait, give me the notes.
I only play by ear. I can't do it.
Yeah.
I can't do it.
Yeah.
Like
that's what I do.
B flat.
There you go.
A.
And then the symbol 4. Dominant 7. This is really easy. You'll see this so many times.
Oh, this is C7, one of the songs.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So then, C7 is going to sound a little bit like this. That is the dominant 7 chord.
I like that.
Alright.
Yeah, that's the one you'll hear very often. Okay?
Alright.
Then we're gonna have minor seventh chord. Wait, is that right? Yeah. Minor seventh chords. And I think you got give me the scale degrees for this one.
One. Flat 3.
Flat 3.
5-7.
Is that 5-7 or
something?
5.
Seven.
I'm guessing flat 5.
Flat 5? No.
I think 5 is natural.
Just 5.
Yeah.
So just 5.
And then?
Maybe flat 7?
Maybe?
Seven.
Yes or no?
Just no,
yes.
Natural 7. Natural
7.
No.
It's flat.
Flat 7. Flat 7.
Yeah.
You'll see this as C minor 7. Give me the notes for this one, guys.
C flat.
B flat. G.
Yeah.
And then, again, like the triads, this is going to get progressively, like, more disgusting.
Ew.
Alright, so we're going to have 1, flat 3, 5, and flat 7. So. Alright? Those are your minor 7th chords. Alright? Ooh, here we go. Here's where it gets fun. Half a minute. Half a minute. Okay, I think you guys can guess this one. Give me the scale degrees for this one.
One.
Three.
Three flat.
Three?
Three flat.
Three
what do we have up here?
Three flat.
Flat three.
Flat three.
Flat three.
Okay.
And then 5 and 7.
No.
Five sharp.
What? Flat five. And then what about the 7?
Natural.
No.
What?
Flat seven two.
What?
So much flat. So much for being half diminished.
You think half flat?
That's more like 3/4.
No, wait till fully diminished. Huh? This is chord progression 101.
Chord progression 101.
This is my entry level course to chord progression.
With Professor X.
Yeah. ask Andrew. So we have give me the notes.
C, E flat, B, G, G.
Wait, no,
G flat.
G flat.
G flat. G flat.
B flat.
B flat. Yeah.
Alright.
Man.
I have my magic chord maker right here.
Ooh.
That's fine. All right. Oh, fine. I have diminished. Right?
Yeah.
And then when you go on the piano, maybe we'll go to the piano after this. You'll see how. Alright. Alright. Wait, simple. This is where it gets kind of cool. We're gonna have C. Circle with a slash through it.
Ooh.
Seven.
Ooh.
Right. Have you seen those yet, Jazz? I don't think we have.
Yeah.
We have.
Nicole, high five.
All right.
Yes, we have. And then, fully diminished, this is where it gets fun. Give me the scale degrees.
One.
Okay.
Three, flat.
Flat three?
Yeah, flat three.
Next.
Five.
Nope.
Sharp.
What do you have up here?
Flat five.
This is chord progression 101 for jazz.
Ah, high five.
And then what about the seven, guys?
I think seven would be natural.
Nope.
Sharp?
Nope.
It can't be flat.
Yeah, it can't be sharp.
It's natural. What?
No.
You're all wrong. Double flat.
What? Double flat?
Double flat.
Of course.
How is that?
That's literally a whole step down.
Yes, that's a whole step down. So
this makes me six.
Well, I wouldn't write six. I wouldn't do that.
Okay, fine.
I would do that.
Double four.
But this is basically saying, drop two half steps. All right, give me the notes, guys.
All right, C.
E flat.
G flat.
Hey. Yeah, this is probably the nastiest chord you're gonna get.
Yeah.
Besides just smashing the keys, okay?
Nasty, like filthy.
Filthy, yeah, like Michael Anderson. He's gonna watch the video. Like, alright, cymbal is, I guess you guys can probably figure this one out. E-T.
Holster.
No slash,
just.
Seven.
C, circle, then
probably
seven.
My C is different from your C.
My C? Well, okay, this is your C major. Like, this is for C major for everyone. So, like, I could start this off on G major and change all of it. This scale degrees is what's really important here. This is more for example. Okay? So, fully diminished. Oh, God. When you play them all together.
It's not
I'll go in order. Major 7. Dominant.
Go ahead.
Alright, so we're gonna have a little quiz coming up here. Yes! My mom tried that. Same.
Fast forward.
Alright, we're saying. Wait, I'll erase this.
Yeah. Weird Asian dance.
Alright, so. Things that you want to focus on to... Wait, I'm getting ahead of myself. When you're improvising, what are you essentially doing to the audience?
Adding your style to the song.
Style of what? Like, what are you... The audience, let's say the audience knows nothing about how to play the saxophone, nothing about music. All they can do is hear you. What are you trying to do? What are you trying to do to really get them to really enjoy your solo?
Entertain us.
By doing what?
Making it pretty noisy.
Yeah.
Tell them a story. You're telling them a story through your instrument, without words, right?
Mm-hmm.
They do it in country. They do it in rap. They do it in Mississippi heat music. I don't know.
Bluegrass.
So, in order to portray that story, what are some things that you might want to focus on? What are some things you use to tell your story?
There's no work to be done other than using the calculator.
Okay.
Maybe certain ways you play it. Maybe you add a growl somewhere.
And maybe inflection, maybe?
Trills?
Yeah. Inflection.
Pretty good.
Could dynamics be
anything? MX plus B. Slow intercept
button? No!
I couldn't hear you.
Dynamics.
Nice. Nice. Noise.
I mean, this might be a no-brainer, but rhythm.
Yeah. Rhythm, anything else? You tell me.
I'm thinking. I'm really thinking about this. Like,
you got your notes.
Scoop da da.
You got your inflection. You alright? You got your dynamics. Alright, then you got your rhythm. This Gabby's gotten pretty good at it.
Yeah.
You can hold out alone though, but make sure you put some rhythm into it. Don't just you put some rhythm into it. Make it your own. When you're telling a story, you gotta put some of these things in there, right? So let's say you stand up, you don't do any of these things, you just stand there and look at the audience. Is that a very good story? You don't like that story too much? What if your mom went to go read you a bedtime story and then just brought out the book and closed it and walked away? Right? You have to hit these things in order to portray your story, alright? And then what are some things that you can do to tell your story? Like, not things you can do to tell your story. What kind of thing, what kind of feelings can the audience get from you telling your story?
Wow.
What?
Just wow.
Wonder, amazement,
goosebumps. Amazement. I think it may be some...
Sadness, too.
A sadness?
Emotion, general.
You gotta make them feel something.
Emotion in general. Emotion in general. Because when you're telling this story, you can, in a ballad, you can make something seem sad. And a funk song, you can really get into it, get
funky,
get excited. You know?
You can add groove.
Yeah, you can make it a happy soul. You can play some Pop Goes the Weasel. I don't know. Some Christmas music. I've heard some Christmas licks in the middle of songs that don't belong in Christmas time. You know. So you decide how you want the audience to feel based on how you play. So if you feel in some kind of way, you can make the audience feel some kind of way, alright?
What if I want to make them feel triggered?
Triggered? So if you're feeling just on the edge, you're just triggered. You're just ready. With your soul, you can make the audience feel the same way. Alright? Alright. So now here comes quiz time.
Oh.
Wait, you guys got this down?
Yeah.
Oi.
So this is basically just not the improv right now.
Yeah, so you see, you're here. Mr. A says, Kenneth, solo. Kenneth, what are the notes? This is D7, so you start on your D. So I want you to think about, give me the notes for D major, the whole scale.
Uh-oh.
Starting on D.
Sharp, G, A.
D.
Mm-hmm.
F.
No, don't give me the chords yet. Just give me the whole scale. D major scale.
D, E, F.
F or F sharp?
F sharp.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I
want to
see this.
It's so
yeah. Keep going, you're almost there. B.
B, C. Wait, D. Wait, C sharp.
C sharp.
Sharp.
It is. Okay,
do it.
That's D major. So those are your notes.
Yeah.
And then D minor 7, what are the scale degrees for D minor 7? It's, no, don't give me notes here, just give me the degrees.
So D.
Wait, give me the numbers first.
Okay.
Numbers.
One.
One.
Yeah. Steady.
Oh,
one, three flat.
Flat three?
Flat three. Five.
Yeah,
and then flat seven. There you go. Nice job, Kenneth. So then now knowing that, and we already established what D major was. What are the notes?
So D.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Regular F then, since it's like flat.
Regular F. So it was F sharp, we flatted it, now it's F. Fifth.
A.
And
C, just regular C.
Regular C. Alright? That's your minor. Okay, you hit these tones, alright? Yeah. You play some nice little riff with these notes, alright? And then now you get to G minor 7.
Okay.
Well, so we already established that these are the degrees for it, right? So okay. Just give me the notes.
Are you gonna wait for your mama?
Just the notes in the scale?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's G.
Sure.
Sure, you want me to give you, right? A. That's the second degree.
Oh,
the third.
Oh, so just the tri. So just the. Okay, so. B flat,
there you go. Doing pretty good. Oh, whoa.
Okay.
B flat.
D.
Good job. Go. And then what?
My mom's friendly, my dad's more. If you get through my dad's.
Is there really an F flat?
No, wait, what's the seventh in the G major? Yeah, so then you flat it. So this is your regular F. Alright?
Okay, I went to Canada.
Alright. So this is what you're gonna be.
My dad talking.
With a little bit of practice,
no,
you know,
no,
just a little bit of thinking about it every now and then,
uh-huh.
You'll get used to it. Do I hit every chord change? Heck no. But when you're looking for the chord changes, now you can read through them. Now you're gonna be saying, obviously, oh, D minor 7. I know 1 flat 3, 5 flat 7. That's the point I'm at right now. I can say this right here, and then I get into it, okay? So I'm like, okay, it's got an F in it, it's got an A in it, okay? I can play these notes. But then every other note in this scale is just going to be the notes that's in G major. These are the only two notes that are different in that scale then. So I can play the whole scale, but with the new scale degrees in there, okay? So we have... I'm gonna play D major 7. I probably should have swung that, but too late. And then, so I'm gonna add the F and the C in there, alright? So. Alright? So, what scale does that remind you of? It's like. C major, but now it's D minor 7. It's got the same notes, same exact notes as C major, right? No flats, no sharps. But now it starts on D, which changes the chord tone. So if I play C major, it'd be... But now, since it's D minor 7, now it's got that minor sound to it, and now... You're telling your audience a story. Alright? Okay, you guys passed that quiz. You guys passed that quiz. Oh, really? Okay. How are we doing on time? We're at 3 o'clock. Okay, we're making it. I think I have two more to go. Corn dogs, corn tones, boats. I feel like this is something for you guys to write down, but I don't know how well I'd be able to teach it. I might need a better marker for me to teach this.
Get a black marker.
Black marker. Good idea. You're a smart one. Just like Kendall, just like Josh.
Taking knapsack?
Yeah. Knapsack.
I wonder if Angel's going to send us any more interesting pictures.
Yeah, I wonder.
He sent nudes or something?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah, we had a good night last night.
What do you do? Is there something that we're gonna have to take a quick break?
What in the heck?
Pictures. What the? Wait, well, hold on.
Go.
So we're gonna have. I hope this works. Oh my god, that's so much better.
Oh.
Hallelujah.
This is like kind of just extra stuff that you guys might relate with. I don't know.
Even the teacher's having trouble. Let's take a quick commercial break
this
here.
This is
F. Oh, shoot.
What?
Alright. Hold on. I'm gonna pause it. I'm gonna pause this real quick.
Alright. So, this is gonna.
You know when it's going out.
I
kind
of want to
buy one though.
It's so stupid, fun.
Hey, I had one.
If it's stupid but it's fun, it's not stupid.
It actually looks kind of nice too. I'm so mad. Alright, so in any scale, this is gonna be what? So okay. Here's C major 7, but in the second chord will always be a minor 7. The third chord will always be a minor 7. The fourth will always be a major. Fifth would be a dominant 7. Sixth would be a minor 7. And 7 would be a half diminished. So if I change the scale, the chords wouldn't, the notes would change, but the chords wouldn't. So if I said, In G major, for the fourth, what's gonna be that chord? It's gonna be a major 7 chord, right? Is that chicken?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Good.
All right. So, but the reason why I'm doing this is it's gonna get kind of crazy. So bear with me. This is gonna be Ionian. This is gonna be Dorian. This is gonna be
crab. I should really eat this with rice.
This is Physian.
Mmm.
Woke. like I said, this is exercise, so you can write this down. I haven't actually like sat down and really like try to memorize this yet, but here's some information. So there's this app I use. This is to practice my reading chord changes, because you know in band you only get like maybe one chance to improv, and it's like 16 measures, 8 measures, you know. Sometimes you really don't get to practice reading chord changes, and when you do get to practice them, it's like G sharp 13, 11. I'm like, I don't know what this is. So then, like, you're just kind of stuck. So in order to practice reading your chord changes, hi Donnelly. I have downloaded this app called iReal Book 7, or I think iReal. Let me find it.
iReal Pro.
iReal Pro. Okay. And in this app, you can download. You can download every jazz song. Okay. Well, not every jazz song, but.
We said Chicago song was in there, right?
I don't think so. But you can put it in there.
A link will be down
these are, kinda, these are all jazz
for,
songs.
Any people that
and let's say I click on My Favorite Things. I love that song. Okay? I get the chord changes to it, right? And then not only do I get the chord changes to it, but I can slow it down, I can speed it up, I can repeat it, I can change the style of it. So I'm going to play this. So you can sit there in your room, headphones, stereo, and you can practice D major 7. You can sit there and practice your playing over D major 7 and changing it to B minor 7. I'm going to turn this so you maybe feel a little better. D major 7, A major 7, D major 7. So then you can change these. You can pick any song. I suggest picking a slow song at first. You know, that's what I'm doing. So then that way you can practice.
Good job. Yeah, good job.
Good stuff.
Good stuff.
That way.
I feel better, by the way.
You better.
Finally, after I had a panic.
So with that app, like, are there, versions that we're, like, playing in jazz also in that thing, too?
No, like, big band tunes?
What was it called? Variations? Like our variation of a song there also.
Yeah.
Because like there's like different variations by different composers.
Yeah. Okay. These are.
Or these like actual.
It's kind of weird because people you can make songs on this. Like I made my own song.
Ooh.
It's called Troubled Nest. And it's got standard chord progressions. Got. You know, I really don't even listen to it as jazz. I change it to house music.
Hey.
This is how you should listen to it. Because it's so Argentinian to reggae.
Oh my gosh.
Reggae.
Oh my gosh.
Ooh.
So.
Bob Marley, man.
So. The only problem with this app is it's like $13. Editing.
What?
It's $13. It's kind of steep, and I have the book right there. This is in line with that book, okay? So it's same company. So that book is $30.
Holy!
This app is $13. And now for this combo, we have two E flat real books for some reason. Just because John already had one, and then I bought one.
This is
where most of our music is gonna come from. But if we're gonna have, we're gonna need one E flat book, okay? So we have two E flat players. So I don't know if you guys are gonna, split it $15. I'll buy it for you or something like that. I don't know. Sorry to associate prices with things.
You can always legally do that. You know what I do?
What?
I jailbroke my phone and I got it for free.
No, he jailbroke the wait, I don't know if we want to get this on camera.
Yeah,
you might want to wipe that. Wipe the evidence.
I mean, like, he's going to edit
it. He jailbroke his phone, he got the app for free. That's nice. That's a practice chord change. But for songs, So when I say, all right, we're gonna play Cottontail. Okay. So instead of having to sit there and waste a day transposing something, you guys already have it. You know what I mean?
And it's nice to see the chord changes are in there as well.
And the chord changes are in here too. So then you get the backing track that's you play
really,
over it.
Yeah, that's really convenient.
Yeah, so the only problem is we need an E-flat book. So, I don't know if we'll all pitch in for that. I want to get an E-flat book. So, yeah.
Where'd you buy your book from?
Amazon.
I could check WBW. I bought my book for like 25, the John Coltrane one. I got that one $20 from Jesse. Mm-hmm. So, I mean... Yeah. Just gotta look around. Just see. I already have an account for WBW, so I can order that for you if you guys want me to, too.
Yeah, so
like
we'll,
I said, you gotta talk about money and how
I was gonna work. I'll pitch in for this, too, because I really want this to work out. So you guys will be reading off the same book, and John and I will be reading off the same book.
Alright.
Like I said, for performances, I don't know how many horn players we can have. It's for a combo. If I'm gonna do 8 times, you're gonna do 6 times, Kenneth's gonna do 5. And John's gonna do 4. That's gonna be like a 25-minute song.
Oh my god!
And then plus, of course, you can't leave out drums, bass, and piano.
Mm-hmm. Do we need books for them as well?
Well, see, the thing is with them, they mainly Rodney doesn't need notes because he is a drummer. You tell him medium rhythm. Swing, he'll get it right.
Yeah.
And then we can tweak it. We can actually bring up the song on YouTube, listen to it, and then we can kind of tell him what we want. Kevin, he'll need chord changes.
Yeah.
Okay, if there's a song where he actually needs a rhythm, I'll write that out for him, or we can do it. Because now we all have the knowledge for it. Or piano, I'm assuming that right now, because this is my beginning stage, I'm assuming that I can hand them chord changes and they can just comp on them. Because mm-hmm. That's what this app does, it just comps on the chord changes.
You know, piano players, they should know.
And not only can I find the chord changes on the internet, but now I have the app as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I can change it to just... a concert pitch, and I can just write out the chord changes or whatever.
Yeah, I think the app would be more reliable than the internet, too, because you mm-hmm. might find some funky stuff on there.
Yeah, and then with the app, too, let's say the song's, like, really, like, kind of difficult. It's, like, G-sharp, mm-hmm. like, something. We can change it. We can change it to, like, C major. It's not gonna sound right, but we can change it to either practice or whatever. I'm just kind of intro you.
Like I said, we will have to investigate on this.
Yeah, so the only problem is we have everything we need except a piano player. Right?
Yep.
I don't know, Ian seems to be avoiding me a little bit. But honestly, I think he'd be a perfect fit.
He says he's interested, but he says...
Because we can make money off of this. So, I mean, it's not a big time commitment. Yeah, you have to practice a little bit. You know, I can see Kenneth in his room on Saturday. Yeah, at least...
I think I'd be playing like one note at any time, and then they'll like tell me to quiet down because you know no one's really gonna like the big noise.
Wait, I sometimes practice in my garage, my basement, or I go to like a park or something to practice. Mm. You know, mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes you know my mom has a headache. Sometimes or my mm-hmm. dad's watching his favorite movie. He just needs to hear his favorite movie. He don't like to hear my crappy practicing in my altissimo. So, yeah, I relate, Kenneth. And I think most band kids have to relate to that.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Basement.
Basement, I love
basement. I don't know.
Basement.
Yeah, basement. I have a feeling that if I play it, what if I'm, like, practicing and all of a sudden the sound wave, like, brings out, like, a million spiders and they just land on me.
Or I have an uncle.
You have an uncle?
Yeah.
What about your uncle?
The guy with the band.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, we could use his... little basement studio.
Yeah. Like on a Sunday, we're like, let's go up to the basement studio. Scare up, do that. Yeah. Are you still filming me?
Yeah, why?
It's a conversation.
Oh, well.
Why don't we put the stop button on this thing?
Carnon's at college right now.
Before we continue with this conversation,
I don't know the stop button on this thing.
Listen to that song of the reggae version.
I'm blind.
Just background music.
Wait, my song?
Background music.
Remember Platform 9 3/4?
Oh, that's terrible.
So, wait, where do we leave off? Oh, practicing. Yeah, so... Hey, can you have an iPhone 5C, right?
Yeah.
Can you jailbreak his phone so we can get that app?
iPhone 5C, no you can't because I don't know. Aww. Some reason.
They got smart about it, basically.
Come on, man.
It's
wait,
they're absolutely useful.
What iOS is it running?
iOS 9.
Nine.
The latest 9.
I put real chord changes into this. I'm so proud of myself.
This is good. I just got it.
Yeah.
So.
I might be able to share this with you. You can like jam onto my house music. My house slash jazz music.
I'm just here like pretending to smoke from this pencil.
Get that sound back. Yeah, this album's gonna be fun, guys. I swear. This is gonna be fun. So please talk to Ian, man. Encourage him. This is gonna be a good time.
You should just. He watches my videos. You should just tell him right now.
Ian, this is gonna be fun. We got reggae music. Literally, all we need you to do is play chords, man. You'll have some sick solos. Play at some restaurants once we get established here. And
we got the reggae man.
We got the reggae man. This is gonna be a good time, okay? So.
It's like
1.9.5. Don't do it.
That's good.
Just downgrade.
Yeah,
just downgrade it. Because.
Possible?
Yeah. You need to go on your computer for that. But. Yeah.
So, this is gonna be fun. You get a little bit of practicing in it. Like I said, even just thinking about it helps. Like, you're sitting in math class, you're a little bit bored, D minor 7, and think to yourself what the notes would be. Or whatever. So, any questions right now?
I think that's it.
I might create a chat for us. Like I said, continue to talk to Ian. If you guys see Ian, encourage him. Nothing but positive words.
Ian, join us already.
Because this is gonna be fun, guys. Very
nice.
We're just
3 nights of 18-hour torture sessions out of doom, man.
So. Thank you, Professor X.
So now you can also use this in jazz band now. So now Andrew, now you can see, because now you have Scott's sheet now, so you see G7. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're pretty good with your ear.
Yeah, but
now you can play that flat 7. Mm-hmm. Now you can play that everything else that's in there. Get it, Kenneth.
Ooh.
Get it, Kenneth. Get it, Kevin.
Hey, turn the camera away from me.
Okay. So.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. You ready?
Wait, what are we doing? Yeah, yeah. I just gotta pee.
Just gotta pee?
Mm-hmm. And chew some gum. No, okay.
Alright, I'll see you guys later. I gotta go. I'm at that car and we might need it.
So.
Anyone going to Wendy's today?
I'm gonna try.
I'm gonna try. I might at least
get a bag.
Mom, can we go to Wendy's?
I want a frosty.
I need a bread.
I want a